continuing with the same Portia Starler, she says, "Such a hair is madness of youth to skip over measures of good counsel, the cripple. But this reason is not the fashion to choose a husband. Oh me, the word choose, I may neither choose whom I would, nor refuse whom I dislike. So is the will of a living daughter curbed by the will of a dead father. It is not hard, Nariza, that I cannot choose nor refuse none." Now she says that youths can be advised, they can be given suggestions, they can be given lots of rules and regulations to follow, but when their heart is full of hot desires and passions, it does not listen to all those advices. Then all those advices become crippled, they become lame, they are just a cold decree. Because the youth will just go and do something it wants to. It will even leap into the wrongdoing, just like a hare who is trained too much, but still goes and falls into the trap of a captive. Now she says that the word choose is not made for me. I have not been given a right to choose. I am bound by the will of my own father. This is for the first time that we are introduced to the will of Portia's father. Actually, the will was designed in which Portia's father had said that she could marry only a suitor who chooses the right casket among the gold, silver and lead. It was that the three caskets were kept and only one contained the portrait of Portia. Any suitor who will choose the correct casket which has the portrait of Portia would only be allowed to marry Portia. So Portia did not have a choice. She could not choose a husband of her own choice, nor she could deny anyone she did not like. So she is just pointing it out to Nariza and she says that I don't have that word choice in my dictionary. That is, I am being bound by my dead father's will. I am alive, but I am under the subjugation or the foundation of the will of my dead father. Here she uses a pun in the word will, which means first, wish of Portia who is alive, and second, testament of her father, the father who is already dead. Nariza says, "Your father was very virtuous and holy man at the death. Have good inspirations, therefore, the lottery that he had devised in these three chests of caskets of gold, silver and lead, whereof who chooses his meaning chooses you, will no doubt never be chosen by any rightly, but one who shall rightly love. But what warmth is there in your affection toward these princely suitors that are already come?" Now she says that you don't take it lightly. Your father was full of wisdom, he was a visionary, he was full of inspiration, and any person who is full of wisdom, who is so wise in himself, usually get an inspiration from God. They get a sort of a blessings from God, from heaven, when they are about to die, which advises them to decide properly. So that is the reason your father has been given a proper advice and he has devised this lottery of casket of gold, silver and lead, that no wrongdoer or wrong selector will come and choose you. You will only get a true lover of yours who will choose the right casket, and then you will be married to a true lover. She's actually consoling Portia. Both of them do not know which is the right casket. So she says, "But first of all, just tell me who is the real one whom you like. There are many suitors who have come. What do you feel about them?" Portia, "I pray thee, overname them as thou namest them. I will describe them, and according to my description, level at my affection." Now she says that you just come and name them. The moment you name them, I will tell you what I feel about them. It's not that she's affected by them, she's in love with them. She's just saying that whatever is my feeling, I'll let you know. So they are teasing each other. And just a moment ago, she was in a sad mood. Now she becomes playful, and we see the difference of the opinion. See, Antonio was in the melancholic mood right up till the time of the first scene was over, till Bassanio has taken the loan. But here, Portia becomes very naughty and mischievous the very next moment she is named about the suitors, And now we see how she makes a fun of all the suitors. She ridicules them. She makes a fun of them.